What's up, everyone? Thanks for checking out my RC Retro channel. I'm here again with my Vanquish. What could I say? I love the thing. I love it so much that after my last video, when I said I was going to clean it and shelf it, I had a change of heart because I had so much fun with it. So I decided to put and swap out the mechanical speed control for just a simple Tamiya TBLE-02 ESC. And a Dynatech 01 motor. Now, I don't see the label on there, and neither do you guys, because for some reason, the way the motor is seated in there, the label is facing down. I was playing around with the end cap on it, and just the way it's screwed in, either which way I turn it, you can't see the label, but I do have the timing turned all the way up. So that everyone could see that there's no cheating here, we are starting off at 0 miles per hour. Alright, so I have the Vanquish back home, and I just wanted to talk a little bit about what happened. The ESC was shutting down. We call that thermal shutdown. I guess it's a safety feature to prevent the ESC from overheating. Basically, this is not a strong enough ESC to handle the power of the Dynatech 01R. A few weeks back, I was doing a video series on my egress, and I was looking for some advice on the Tamiya Legends Facebook page about what ESC I can use to handle a Dynatech 02H. And I asked if I could just use the Tamiya Special, as I call it, the generic ESC that they throw in to a lot of their re-release kits. And people said no way, wouldn't be able to handle the power. It could only handle up to a certain turn motor, whether it's brush or brushless. And some people recommended getting a Hobbywing 1060. I think it's a 1060. I'm not sure of the exact number. couple people said that the 1060 wouldn't even work either with a Dynatech 02. However, I ran this twice, both times with a LiPo battery, and had no issues whatsoever, so it worked. And considering that this is a more powerful motor than a Dynatech 01, I'm probably gonna end up taking this out and putting it into the Vanquish so I can run the Dynatech 01 and do another speed test and hopefully get better results. I'm thinking maybe, you know, that's why it didn't get to, you know, its top speed. I mean, it was 24 miles per hour, and that might be its top speed, but I just want to make certain for sure that, you know, it could or it couldn't go any faster, you know, with a different speedo in there. So I'm going to clean this up and get this speed control into there. Now, what's the moral of the story? Moral of the story is I should have listened to everyone who offered their advice in the first place and would have saved myself a little time. But I guess that's, you know, trial and error, and I had to see it for myself. It's a little humbling. Didn't quite go as planned, but listen, I still made the most of it out there. And either which way, it's a learning experience for myself and for some of my viewers. Don't make the same mistake that I made, right? So if you liked my video, please hit the like button and subscribe. And if you're already a subscriber, I thank you for all your support. And keep a lookout for some future videos. Thanks.